गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज अवर थर्ड लेक्चर ऑन मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल्स। सो टुडे वी आर जस्ट गोइंग टू स्टडी द मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मटेरियल। नाउ एज फार एज मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल्स आर कंसर्न, वी आर हैविंग डिफरेंट मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल्स डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द बिहेवियर ऑफ दीज मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल व्हेनेवर दे आर केप्ट इन व्हाट एक्सटर्नल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड। द बिहेवियर ऑफ मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल व्हेनेवर दे आर केप्ट इन व्हाट एक्सटर्नल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड डिपेंडिंग अपॉन विच दे आर क्लासिफाइड इन टू थ्री कैटेगरीज। आइदर दे आर कॉल्ड डाई मैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंस और दे आर कॉल्ड पैरा मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल और दे आर कॉल्ड फेरो मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल। मीन्स मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल दे आर क्लासिफाइड इंटू थ्री कैटेगरीज, डाई मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल, पैरा मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल एंड फेरो मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल। सो दिस क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल इट डिपेंड्स ऑन हाउ दिस मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल दे आर बिहेविंग व्हेनेवर दे आर केप्ट इन व्हाट एक्सटर्नल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड। नाउ वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टी इट इज नोन एज मैग्नेटिक ससेप्टिबिलिटी एंड इट इज डिनोटेड बाय ए लेटर काय, एन अल्फाबेट व्हाट काय। सो द मैग्नेटिक ससेप्टिबिलिटी इट इज एक्चुअली द रेशियो ऑफ व्हाट मैग्नेटाइजेशन टू दैट ऑफ व्हाट मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी। रिमेंबर एज फार एज दिस मैग्नेटिक ससेप्टिबिलिटी इज कंसर्न, हियर द रेंज ऑफ मैग्नेटिक ससेप्टिबिलिटी फॉर डिफरेंट मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल इट इज लाइक दिस। सो इफ वी आर हैविंग ए डाई मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल, फॉर डाई मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल द रेंज ऑफ मैग्नेटिक ससेप्टिबिलिटी मीन्स एनी डाई मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल इट्स मैग्नेटिक ससेप्टिबिलिटी इट मस्ट लाई विद इन द रेंज ऑफ -10^-5. The magnetic susceptibility for any paramagnetic material it lies within the range of from 0 to 10^-3. Remember, magnetic susceptibility, as it is a ratio of two physical quantities which are having same unit, same dimension. So that's why magnetic susceptibility is what? Dimensionless. So the magnetic susceptibility for paramagnetic material, it lies within the range of 0 to 10^-3. 0 to 10^-3. And that of ferromagnetic substance, ferromagnetic material, the magnetic susceptibility it lies within the range of 10^2 to 10^3. So remember, the magnetic susceptibility of diamagnetic substance, we know that it is negative and very very small, and is ranging from -10^-3 to -10^-5. Magnetic susceptibility of paramagnetic substance is ranging from what? 0 to 10^-3, while that of magnetic susceptibility of ferromagnetic substance it is ranging from 10^2 to that of what? 10^3. Means magnetic susceptibility of ferromagnetic substance is very very high and is positive and greater than 0. Magnetic susceptibility of paramagnetic substance is positive, but it is what? Small. Here, this magnetic susceptibility is large, positive and very large, positive but very small, and here it is negative. Magnetic susceptibility chi for diamagnetic substance is what? Negative. So, depending upon how the magnetic material they will behave whenever they are kept in external magnetic field. We will classify magnetic material into what? Diamagnetic material, paramagnetic material and ferromagnetic material. And one of the important characteristics that what is the magnetic susceptibility for these three different types of magnetic material. And here is the range of the magnetic susceptibility for diamagnetic, paramagnetic and that of what? Ferromagnetic substance. Now we will see in detail regarding diamagnetic substance, then paramagnetic substance, then ferromagnetic substance, and at last we will compare between di, para and that of what? Ferromagnetic substance. Now as far as the diamagnetic substance is concerned, diamagnetic material. So atom or molecule of diamagnetic material, atom or molecule of diamagnetic material consists of completely filled electron orbit. Means if I say this is an atom of diamagnetic material and this is the outermost orbit of diamagnetic material. If the number of electron in the outermost orbit they are even, it means diamagnetic material, their atom consists of what? Completely filled electron orbit. Completely filled electron orbit means if this electron has net magnetic moment pointing upward, if this electron has net magnetic moment pointing downward, and because the atom of diamagnetic substance or diamagnetic material consists of completely filled electron orbit, so the net magnetic moment of atom is zero. Net magnetic moment of atom is zero. So remember, those material whose atom or molecule consists of completely filled electron orbit, they have a net magnetic dipole moment equal to zero. Means they do not have any net magnetic moment. Or those material whose atom consists of completely filled electron orbit, due to which the net magnetic moment of atom, net magnetic dipole moment of atom is zero, such material they are called as a diamagnetic material. Such materials they are called as what? Diamagnetic material. Means in short we can say that the atom of diamagnetic material do not exhibit any magnetic property. It will not behave like a magnet. So the atom of diamagnetic material will have a net magnetic dipole moment M equal to zero. Means atom of diamagnetic material do not exhibit any magnetic property. It will not exhibit what? Any magnetic property. Now, when such a diamagnetic substance, when such a diamagnetic material, they are kept in non-uniform magnetic field. Non-uniform magnetic field means here field may be weaker, here field may be stronger. And when a diamagnetic substance is kept, suppose here, then it is observed that diamagnetic substance has a tendency, it has a tendency to move from stronger part of magnetic field towards weaker part of magnetic field. What is the property of diamagnetic substance? Diamagnetic substance or diamagnetic material, whenever they are kept in non-uniform magnetic field, they have a tendency to move from stronger part of magnetic field towards what? Weaker part of magnetic field. It means in other words we can say that the diamagnetic materials, they are repelled by magnet or they are repelled by magnetic field. So see here, these are the three properties. The atom of diamagnetic material has net magnetic dipole moment equal to zero. Means atom of diamagnetic material do not exhibit the magnetic property. Second thing, when diamagnetic material is kept in what? Non-uniform magnetic field, then it has a tendency to move from stronger part of magnetic field towards the weaker part of magnetic field. Third, the diamagnetic material, they are repelled by magnetic field. They are repelled by magnet, or they are repelled by what? A magnetic field. They are repelled by a magnet or by a magnetic field. Now, as far as this diamagnetism is concerned, suppose this diamagnetic substance, diamagnetic material, when it is kept in external magnetic field, we know that whenever a diamagnetic material is kept in external magnetic field, no doubt it gets magnetized. But it gets magnetized in a direction opposite to that of direction of externally applied magnetic field. Listen carefully what I am saying. Whenever any diamagnetic material, it is kept in what? External magnetic field. No doubt it gets magnetized. But it gets magnetized in a direction opposite to that of direction of externally applied magnetic field. Now, how it can be explained? Just see here. Suppose we are having a diamagnetic material, and I will just look at one of the atom of diamagnetic material. Suppose this is one of the atom of diamagnetic material having two electrons. Means, as far as diamagnetic materials are concerned, the atoms of diamagnetic material consist of what? Completely filled electron orbit. So here I am having a pair of electrons in the outermost orbit of diamagnetic material. In the outermost orbit of what? Diamagnetic material. So, in absence of external magnetic field, this electron, it may be revolving, it may perform what? Orbital motion in anti-clockwise direction, while the second electron, it will perform orbital motion in what? Clockwise direction. And due to this orbital motion, this electron possesses orbital magnetic moment pointing downward, and due to this orbital motion, this electron possesses orbital magnetic moment pointing upward. So the net orbital magnetic moment or the net magnetic moment of atom, it is vector sum of these two, which are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Hence it becomes equal to what? Zero. They cancel the effect of each other, and as a result of which we can say that every atom of diamagnetic material has zero magnetic dipole moment, or it will not show any magnetic property. But when diamagnetic material is kept in external magnetic field, say here external magnetic field is pointing upward. When diamagnetic material, it is kept in what? External magnetic field. Then how it gets magnetized? In a direction opposite to that of direction of externally applied magnetic field. So as far as these two electrons are concerned, the orbit of these two electrons I have drawn here separately. So whenever diamagnetic material is kept in external magnetic field, what happens? That this externally applied magnetic field, it will interfere. Orbital motion of electron round the nucleus is equivalent to what? Current carrying coil. Equivalent to what? Current loop or current carrying coil. And whenever current loop or current carrying coil is kept in external magnetic field, then we know that current is induced in that loop. Current is induced in that loop. So here also current is induced, and that induced current is suppose I suffix I. This I stands for induced current. So separately I will see what happens to this electron and what happens to another electron. So whenever diamagnetic material is kept in external magnetic field, then according to Lenz's law, EMF is induced in that current loop, because orbital motion of electron round the nucleus is equivalent to what? A current carrying loop. So that induced current, here I will represent induced current by I suffix I. Now here there are two possibilities. Look at this. Induced current is flowing in anti-clockwise direction, and this I represent what? Loop current. It is actually the current resulted due to orbital motion of electron. The value of I depends on speed of electron. So, if the direction of induced current is such that induced current is flowing in a direction same as that of what? Direction of loop current due to this electron. Then the net current here will increase. Both the current they are flowing in the same direction. So the net current here becomes what? I plus II. Net current will increase. And when the net current is increasing, then magnetic dipole moment, which is equal to I into A, as net current increases, it means magnetic dipole moment, this ML, magnetic dipole moment will increase. So the magnetic dipole moment will increase whenever induced current is flowing in a direction same as that of what? Direction of loop current. Now look at the another loop where induced current is flowing in clockwise direction while loop current is flowing in what? Anti-clockwise direction. It means the two current they are flowing in opposite direction. So the net current of this circuit or of this loop, it becomes I minus I dash. It means a net current in this case is reduced, and due to reduction in the current, what happens? Magnetic dipole moment is reduced. So see here, before keeping this diamagnetic material in the external magnetic field, this electron pair will have a magnetic dipole moment which are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction, hence they cancel each other. But as soon as it is kept in external magnetic field, one of the electron, here this electron, where induced current and loop current are in the same direction, as a result of which the net current will increase, this electron will be speeded up and the magnetic moment of this electron will increases in a direction opposite to that of direction of externally applied magnetic field. While in another loop where the induced current and the loop current, they are flowing opposite in direction, therefore the net current will decrease, hence the magnetic moment will decrease. In this way, because magnetic moment of one of the electron increases while other electron will decreases, so the net magnetic moment of atom is not zero, but atom has net magnetic moment pointing in a direction opposite to that of direction of externally applied magnetic field. Or in other words, we can say that whenever diamagnetic substance is kept in external magnetic field, this is north and south, then that diamagnetic substance, it gets magnetized in a direction opposite to that of direction of externally applied magnetic field. So you remember this, because as far as the property of diamagnetic substance is concerned, that whenever a diamagnetic substance is kept in external magnetic field, no doubt it gets magnetized, and it gets magnetized in a direction opposite to that of direction of what? Externally applied magnetic field. Now the same thing here, that when diamagnetic substance is kept in external magnetic field, see here, suppose this is a diamagnetic substance and it is kept in external magnetic field. It is kept in what? External magnetic field. We know that whenever diamagnetic substance is kept in external magnetic field, that external magnetic field will induce the current or will induce the magnetic field in the material of diamagnetic substance. And according to Lenz's law, the direction of that induced magnetic field, see here, this is the north and this is south pole, north and south. External magnetic field is pointing from what? North to south. Here. Now, as a diamagnetic substance is kept in external magnetic field, it will induce magnetic field in the diamagnetic substance. And that induced magnetic field, it is pointing in which direction? It is pointing in a direction opposite to that of what? Direction of externally applied magnetic field. In other words, we can say that whenever diamagnetic substance is kept in external magnetic field, it helps in reducing the external magnetic field. It will reduce what? the external magnetic field. And second thing, whenever it is kept in non-uniform magnetic field, whenever a diamagnetic substance is kept in non-uniform magnetic field, it has a tendency to move from stronger part of magnetic field towards what? The weaker part of magnetic field. Stronger part of magnetic field towards the weaker part of magnetic field. Now let us consider, because we know that as far as a diamagnetic substance is concerned, what are the examples of diamagnetic substance? It may be a copper, it may be a gold, it may be what? A lead, it may be a silicon, it may be a glass, it may be a water, it may be a wood, or it may be a plastic. So these are all examples of diamagnetic substance. These are all examples of diamagnetic substance. So as you know that we are having a U-tube glass called as a manometer, which is used for measurement of pressure. The difference in the height of liquid level in the two arms of manometer multiplied by rho into g. Just here, what is manometer? If I just connect this manometer to a chamber whose pressure we want to determine, when that gas enters, what happens? Here, h is the difference in the height of liquid level, then the pressure exerted by gas, p equal to h rho g. Now, suppose here we are having a U-tube manometer. We are having what? A U-tube manometer, and in that U-tube manometer, suppose a diamagnetic liquid is filled. Diamagnetic liquid is what? Filled. Now, initially, the liquid level in the two are, both of them, they are at the same height. Both are at the same height. As soon as we apply the magnetic field to one of the limb or one of the arm of U-tube manometer, this is north and this is south, means a space between them, it consists of what? Magnetic field. So, when one of the arm of U-tube manometer, which consists of diamagnetic liquid, if I apply the magnetic field, then it is observed that the liquid level in that arm, or that liquid will be pushed down. In that arm to which magnetic field is applied, it means there will be a rise of liquid level in the arm where no magnetic field is applied. So what we conclude? That diamagnetic materials are repelled by magnetic field. They have a property to get repelled. So because diamagnetic materials, they are repelled by a magnetic field, so that's why liquid level in that arm to which magnetic field is applied, it will be moved downward and there will be a rise of liquid level in that arm where there is no magnetic field applied. Now same is the case, again we know that suppose we are having a rod of diamagnetic material. We are having what? A rod of diamagnetic material. And let this rod is kept in. Let this rod is suspended freely in a uniform magnetic field. Freely in a uniform magnetic field. Then it is observed that this rod of diamagnetic material, it will come to rest at that position where length of rod is perpendicular to the direction of magnetic field. What I am saying? When a rod of diamagnetic material is suspended freely in a uniform magnetic field, then it is observed that the rod of diamagnetic material, it will come to rest at that position where the length of rod is perpendicular to the direction of magnetic field. Remember, this rod behaves like a magnetic dipole, and whenever magnetic dipole is suspended in uniform magnetic field, then the magnetic potential energy possessed by that magnetic dipole, it is minus mv cos of theta. Minus mv cos of theta. Means when rod is suspended in a magnetic field, that rod is acted upon by a torque. What that torque is acting on it? एम क्रॉस ऑफ बी, एम क्रॉस ऑफ बी, दिस इज द टॉर्क एक्टिंग ऑन अ रॉड. सो द मैग्नेटिक पोटेंशियल एनर्जी एसोसिएटेड विथ रॉड इज माइनस एम बी कॉस ऑफ थीटा, वेयर थीटा इज एंगल बिटवीन, थीटा इज एंगल बिटवीन एम एंड दैट ऑफ बी. थीटा इज एंगल बिटवीन व्हाट, एम एंड दैट ऑफ बी. रिमेंबर इफ दिस रॉड इज एंटी पैरेलल मीन्स मैग्नेटिक डायपोल मोमेंट इज पॉइंटिंग टुवर्ड द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज पॉइंटिंग टुवर्ड द राइट हैंड साइड. सो इफ दैट रॉड विल कम टू ए पोजिशन वेयर मैग्नेटिक डायपोल मोमेंट एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड दे आर अपोजिटली डायरेक्टेड मीन्स दे आर एंटी पैरेलल टू ईच अदर, मीन्स थीटा इज इक्वल टू 180 डिग्री, एंगल बिटवीन एम एंड बी इज व्हाट 180 डिग्री. वेन थीटा इज 180 डिग्री देन द मैग्नेटिक पोटेंशियल एनर्जी ऑफ फ्रीली सस्पेंडेड मैग्नेटिक डायपोल इट बिकम्स माइनस एम बी इंटू व्हाट इज कॉस ऑफ 180, कॉस ऑफ 180 इज माइनस 1, सो दिस बिकम्स प्लस एम बी. इट मीन्स मैग्नेटिक पोटेंशियल एनर्जी ऑफ रॉड इट बिकम्स मैक्सिमम इफ इट कम टू रेस्ट पैरेलल टू द डायरेक्शन ऑफ एक्स, एंटी पैरेलल टू द डायरेक्शन ऑफ एक्सटर्नली अप्लाइड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. बट रिमेंबर फॉर एंटी पैरेलल पोजिशन मीन्स फॉर दिस पोजिशन वेयर एम एंड बी आर एंटी पैरेलल, मैग्नेटिक पोटेंशियल एनर्जी ऑफ रॉड इज मैक्सिमम. एंड एज फार एज एनी ऑब्जेक्ट इन द यूनिवर्स इज कंसर्न, वेन एवर इट हैज ए मैक्सिमम पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इट इज हाईली अनस्टेबल. That object will try to return back to that position where its potential energy is minimum. So here, rod does not remain anti-parallel to the direction of magnetic field, but it will adjust itself in such a manner where its potential energy becomes minimum. And when rod becomes perpendicular to the direction of magnetic field, then the potential energy associated with rod is minimum and that rod remains stable at a position where its length is perpendicular to the direction of externally applied magnetic field. And the last, that the magnetic susceptibility for diamagnetic material, it is negative. It is what? Small, very small, as well as what? It is negative. So this is all about the diamagnetic material. Now we will see what are paramagnetic material and their properties. So as you know, the magnetic susceptibility is the ratio of magnetization to that of what? Intensity of magnetic field. And this magnetic susceptibility, its value is minus 1 for superconductors. For superconductors. And the magnetic permeability, mu is equal to permeability of free space into 1 plus ka. So as per this relation, this is equal to mu 0 in bracket 1 plus or minus 1, which is equal to 0. Means magnetic permeability of superconductor is 0. What does it mean? What is the physical significance? That mu for superconductor is 0, it means that wherever superconductor, suppose this is a superconductor, and wherever superconductor is kept in external magnetic field, that superconductor won't allow any magnetic lines of force to pass through them. Means because permeability of superconductor is 0, it will expel all the magnetic field. This phenomena is similar to that of a perfect diamagnetism. So superconductors are perfectly diamagnetic substance. As they expel the entire magnetic field, they won't allow any magnetic lines of forces to pass through them wherever they are kept in what? External magnetic field. So this phenomena of expelling the entire magnetic field by a superconductor, which is similar to that of a perfect diamagnetism, this phenomena, it is called as, or this effect, it is called as Meissner's effect. It is called as what? Meissner's effect. So in examination, there might be a question, what is Meissner's effect? You write that magnetic susceptibility for superconductor is minus 1, hence its magnetic permeability is 0, means wherever superconductors are kept in external magnetic field, they won't allow any magnetic lines or forces to pass through them. It means superconductor expels all the magnetic field, and this behavior of superconductor is similar to that of behavior of a perfect diamagnetic substance, and this effect is known as a Meissner's effect. Now, the first type of magnetic material we have discussed already, that is diamagnetic material. The second and very important type of magnetic material is what? Paramagnetic material. So, what are paramagnetic substances? What is the difference between diamagnetic substance and paramagnetic substance? Before that, we will discuss in thorough paramagnetic substance. So, as far as the atoms or molecules of paramagnetic material, they consist of an unpaired electron in their outermost orbit. Every atom of paramagnetic material has an unpaired electron in their outermost orbit, and due to this unpaired electron, every atom of paramagnetic material has net magnetic dipole moment. Every atom of paramagnetic material, due to presence of unpaired electron in their outermost orbit, every atom possesses net magnetic dipole moment. In other words, what we can say about paramagnetic substance? Those material, paramagnetic materials are those material whose atoms are having unpaired electron in their outermost orbit, and due to which every atom will behave like a magnet. Every atom has a net magnetic dipole moment. So every atom of paramagnetic substance, it behaves like a magnet, atomic magnet, tiny atomic magnet. So atoms of paramagnetic substance, they behave like a magnet. They behave like what? A magnet. Now, as far as paramagnetic materials are concerned, if I just consider a sheet of paramagnetic material, can you tell me the example of paramagnetic material? Magnesium or lithium or tantalum or some example from salt, that is MnSO4 or water H2O or oxygen gas. These are the examples of paramagnetic material. Now when paramagnetic material, see here, this is a sheet of paramagnetic material, then every atom of paramagnetic material has what? Net magnetic dipole moment. And let us represent the magnetic dipole moment of every atom by means of an arrow. So in a sheet of paramagnetic material, we are having large numbers of atoms, and each atom has a net magnetic dipole moment. Remember, in absence of any external magnetic field at room temperature, due to thermal excitation or due to thermal agitation, what I am saying? Paramagnetic material, in absence of any external magnetic field at room temperature, due to thermal excitation or due to thermal agitation, magnetic dipole moments of all the atoms in paramagnetic materials, they are randomly oriented. See here, they are randomly oriented. Therefore, the net magnetic dipole moment of paramagnetic material, which is the vector sum of magnetic dipole moments of all the atoms in paramagnetic material, because they are randomly oriented, means they cancel the effect of each other. Hence, the net magnetic moment of paramagnetic material in absence of external magnetic field under ordinary condition, that is at room temperature, ड्यू टू थर्मल एजिटेशन और थर्मल एक्साइटेशन एज अ मैग्नेटिक डायपोल मोमेंट्स ऑफ ऑल द एटम्स आर रैंडमली ओरिएंटेड हेंस द नेट मैग्नेटिक डायपोल मोमेंट ऑफ पैरा मैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंस इट बिकम जीरो. इन अदर वर्ड वी कैन से पैरा मैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंस डज नॉट एग्जिबिट एनी मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टी इन एब्सेंस ऑफ एक्सटर्नल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इवन दो एवरी एटम ऑफ पैरा मैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंस हैज व्हाट नेट मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट. सो लिसन केयरफुली. इवन दो एवरी एटम ऑफ पैरा मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल हैज नेट मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट बट इन एब्सेंस ऑफ एक्सटर्नल मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ड्यू टू थर्मल एक्साइटेशन द मैग्नेटिक डायपोल मोमेंट्स ऑफ ऑल द एटम्स ऑफ पैरा मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल दे आर रैंडमली ओरिएंटेड एज ए रिजल्ट ऑफ विच द नेट मैग्नेटिक मोमेंट ऑफ पैरा मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल इट बिकम जीरो मीन्स पैरा मैग्नेटिक सब्सटेंस डज नॉट एग्जिबिट एनी मैग्नेटिक प्रॉपर्टी. नाउ when the same paramagnetic sheet, when the sheet of paramagnetic material said is kept in external magnetic field, suppose here the sheet, the direction of what externally applied magnetic field. So whenever paramagnetic material is kept in strong external magnetic field at relatively low temperature. Now, why here we are mentioning low temperature? Remember, due to thermal excitation, magnetic dipole moments of atoms are randomly oriented. As a result, paramagnetic material loses the property of magnetization. So, to remove that drawback, here we are already keeping the temperature of paramagnetic material low, so that effect of thermal excitation can be reduced to some extent. So whenever paramagnetic material they are kept in what strong external magnetic field, that is observed that most of the atom their magnetic dipole moments are aligned in the direction of what externally applied magnetic field. As soon as paramagnetic material it is kept in what strong external magnetic field at low temperature, what we observe that the magnetic dipole moment of most of the atom they will align themselves in the direction of externally applied magnetic field. So when magnetic dipole moments of atoms are aligned in the direction of externally applied magnetic field, it means atoms for that position possesses minimum potential energy. Alignment of dipole moment in the direction of external applied magnetic field, it means that atoms they are acquiring what? That position in a material for which their potential energy is minimum. Potential energy is minimum. So, the magnetic dipole moment, net magnetic dipole moment of paramagnetic material, it is actually the vector sum of dipole moment of all the atoms. Most of the atoms, they are aligned in the direction of external magnetic field. So, the paramagnetic material has what? Net magnetic moment. And which is in the direction of externally applied magnetic field. In other words, we can say that whenever paramagnetic materials are kept in strong external magnetic field at low temperature, they get magnetized. They get magnetized in a direction same as that of direction of what externally applied magnetic field. And that can be expressed like this. Suppose here we are having the external magnetic field B. Mean this is north pole, this is south pole, and this is a paramagnetic material. So it gets magnetized with formation of north pole to this side and south pole to this side. So what we can say, paramagnetic substance, whenever they are kept in strong external magnetic field, they get magnetized in the direction of externally applied magnetic field. Remember that paramagnetic substance is strongly magnetized when they are kept in what? Strong external magnetic field. As we go on increasing the strength of magnetic field, then the magnetization of paramagnetic substance will goes on increases. In other words, we can say that the magnetization of paramagnetic substance, it is directly proportional to the strength of externally applied magnetic field. Again, it is observed that the magnetization of paramagnetic material, it is inversely proportional to temperature. It means with the increase in temperature, magnetization of paramagnetic substance it will decrease. Now, the third situation, that paramagnetic substance, here we have kept it in strong external magnetic field, it gets magnetized in the direction of what? Externally applied magnetic field. Now, as soon as we remove this external magnetic field, what happens to paramagnetic substance? It is observed that immediately after the removal of external magnetic field, magnetic dipole moments of all the atoms in a paramagnetic material, once again they are what? Randomly oriented. So that the net magnetic moment of paramagnetic material, it becomes zero. In other words, we can say paramagnetic substance or paramagnetic material, they loses the property of magnetization in absence of what? External magnetic field. In absence of external magnetic field. Now, as far as these paramagnetic substances are concerned, now when paramagnetic material, they are kept in non-uniform magnetic field, what happens to the paramagnetic material? Suppose here there is a strong magnetic field, here there is a weak magnetic field. And we will keep that paramagnetic material near to the weak magnetic field. It is observed that paramagnetic material has a tendency to move from weaker magnetic field towards what? The stronger magnetic field. What I am saying? That whenever paramagnetic materials are kept in what? Non-uniform magnetic field. They had a tendency to move from weaker part of magnetic field towards the stronger part of magnetic field. In other words, you can say paramagnetic materials, they are attracted by the magnetic field or they are attracted by the magnet. They are attracted by the magnetic field or they are attracted by the magnet. Now, again here you can say that if we are having a paramagnetic liquid, if I take a paramagnetic liquid, in U-tube manometer, initially, the level of liquid in the 2R is same. It is observed, as soon as I will apply the magnetic field to one of the R, magnetic field is applied to one of the arm of U-tube manometer, which contains what? Paramagnetic liquid. Then it is observed that there will be a rise of liquid, paramagnetic liquid, in that arm of manometer across which magnetic field is applied, while there will be a fall of liquid in that arm of manometer where no magnetic field is applied. Means from this experiment, one can conclude that paramagnetic materials, they are attracted by what? The magnetic field. Paramagnetic materials, they are what? Attracted by a magnetic field. Now again here there is one more point that you have to remember, that when paramagnetic materials are kept in external magnetic field, this is a paramagnetic material, and when it is kept in external magnetic field, what happens? It gets magnetized in the direction of externally applied magnetic field. Ultimately, it means that the number of magnetic lines of forces passing through paramagnetic materials, they get increased. They get what? Increased. So this is all about a paramagnetic material. Now we will discuss that as far as Pierre Curie is concerned. What Pierre Curie says, that according to Pierre Curie, magnetization of paramagnetic substance, it is directly proportional to the strength of externally applied magnetic field. Whenever paramagnetic substance, it is kept in external magnetic field, it gets magnetized in the direction of externally applied magnetic field. And the magnetization of paramagnetic substance, means degree of magnetization of paramagnetic material, it is directly proportional to what? The strength of externally applied magnetic field. Similarly, magnetization of paramagnetic material, it is inversely proportional to absolute temperature of paramagnetic material. Or magnetization is equal to C into B divided by T, where C is Curie's constant. C is known as what? Curie's constant. Remember, as far as this magnetic field B is concerned, this magnetic field B, it is equal to mu 0 into H. Therefore, this M is equal to C into mu 0 H divided by T. C into mu 0 H divided by T. Or, here we can modify this expression. M, which is the left hand side, and divide this M by H. Take this H in denominator. So that is equal to C mu 0 divided by T. But we know the ratio of magnetization to that of intensity of magnetic field. It is nothing but chi. So chi is equal to C mu 0 divided by T, or we can say this chi is inversely proportional to what? Absolute temperature. Chi is inversely proportional to absolute temperature. So in short, you always remember that the degree of magnetization or magnetization of paramagnetic material is directly proportional to the strength of externally applied magnetic field. It is inversely proportional to what? Temperature of that paramagnetic material. Temperature of paramagnetic material. So this is all about the paramagnetic material that we have discussed today, and in the next period we will just discuss ferromagnetic material separately, and then we will compare diamagnetic, paramagnetic and ferromagnetic substance. Diamagnetic, paramagnetic and that of what? Ferromagnetic substance.